where to today? Shall I just stand around contemplating the meaning of life, or save a civilization, or should I read a few books? This is the problem, you see. You never quite know what you're going to get. When you step out of those doors, it's a whole new mystery. But then again, mysteries are quite fun. They can be. So, where to today, old girl? Where are you taking me? Right. Where to today? Where are you taking me? I have no clue because I haven't set any coordinates. If there's any, like, alerts you want to give me right now, give it to me, because honestly, I'm doing nothing at the moment. Oh. Okay, so this is interesting. The moon. Something is going wrong on the moon. How is that possible? The ice warriors aren't even awake yet. Okay, so I better go and have a look. Or should I just... it's so tempting. Okay, here we go. Let's go and have a look. Landing procedures are engaged. Here we are. Okay, so let's go. Why have you brought me here, old girl? Why here? There's nothing that bad going on. It's just the moon. The moony, moony moon. Ha, let's just hope there's no Jadoon upon the moon. A platoon of Jadoon upon the moon. Oh god, I really am by myself. I could do with a bit of company. Oh, that's interesting. That is very interesting. A crashed ship on the moon. Right then. I think it's right about time that I see what's going on. Let's go!
Nothing much wrong with the ship's internal navigation systems, I can tell by the hum of the ship. Seeing as there's no gravimetric force holding this place together and it's all done just by some kind of, what you call it, oh I don't know, my mind's too busy thinking about what did this, what crashed a spaceship on the moon. From the gravimetric signals, I would say the point of origin will come from the cockpit, but that means the pilot must have done it, so who's the pilot and why did they want to crash a ship on the moon? Guess there's only one way to find out. Let's go.
Hello? Excuse me. Are you the person who crashed the ship, or a survivor? Or do you know what's happening? I just got here, but this doesn't seem to be, like, a good place for anyone, especially one of the crew. So, if you could just let me know what's going on, that would be absolutely splendid. Okay, so, I'm guessing I'm not getting anywhere with you. Can you even hear me, or is something impaired with your hearing? I can help with that. I'm the doctor. Who are you?
Doctor, I am glad you could join me. Hello, Doctor. good of you to join in my ascension.
You? How are you here? That's impossible. The last time I saw you, you were on Earth. You disappeared and took my Sonic. I want that back. I miss it. Give it me.
You will not get this back, Doctor. I have bigger plans for you. Bigger plans for this universe. You, Doctor, are the key to my ascension.
No, Carlifex. I'm not going to be anything to you. Not part of your ascension, not part of your game, not a part of your plan. I know what you're doing here, but if you don't leave right now, or I'm going to have to stop you. I don't want to, but I'll have to. So leave now, or I'm sorry, but I can't be responsible for what happens next.
Doctor, this universe is falling through, and I am here to save it. You see, Doctor, I do not want to kill you. I do not want to hurt you. I want to rule by your side. Together we can reshape and remold the universe, Omega by our side. You remember Omega, don't you?
Of course I remember. But he's dead. I blasted him into oblivion, into antimatter. How are you working with him? Is he alive?
You really think you could defeat him, Doctor? You will never, ever defeat him. He doesn't want to hurt you. He wants to merge with you and become the ultimate being. Antimatter, Time Lord, and human.
That isn't possible. That's worse than the Metacrisis. We can't do that, even if it was gonna do it. We can't. It's just scientifically, strategically, and impossibly crazy. How can you contemplate this working?
Doctor, look upon me and see the truth. I am your true vessel. And if you choose to go against us, we have different ways of doing our plan. Are you with us or against us? Choose.
I don't know. I don't know what to do. It's scientifically impossible what you're asking me to do, but it's also a good point if you think about it. If the universe is falling apart, if it's the only way to save it is by having a half-human, half-antimatter, half-Time Lord being, it does make sense, but you're missing the obvious. And that is, I would never, ever join you if you're the last person on Earth, on the moon, or in the universe. If this universe is falling apart, I will save it. Me alone. If you want to stand in my way, be my guest, but never, ever, ever try and make me to become you, because that will never happen.
It will. You will become me, and we will rule the universe together. I'll see you soon, Doctor.
Another mystery, another timeline, another bad guy to defeat. I suppose I get back to the TARDIS, but wait, what was that? What was that right over there? Oh no, It's a missile. A missile directed towards Earth. But no, that isn't possible. How is that? Fenric, he must have put this idea into the greatest minds on Earth. Oh no. I gotta get over there, but how? How? Not enough time. Think. Bingo! Gravity. Gravity is fiction. It doesn't actually exist. It's part of the ship. So if I leave the ship, I can Michael Jackson it. And moonwalk. Let's hope this works. Let's go! Oh my god, this is scary. How does Spider-Man do this? Right, land, and... Oh! Okay, so now, all I have to do is reassert my gravity using my mind. Wait, what is that? No, that is not good, not good at all. This is a retroactive bomb made from pieces of a dead TARDIS, and that is the missile to Earth behind me. How do I defuse this? I don't know. I don't know how to do it. I haven't got a sonic screwdriver. No, gonna have to do it freestyle. Right, let's do this. Aha! Got it. It's in one of the three stages, the three boxes. This is gonna take a while. Oh, wait. Carlifix has left me a note. Haha, you will not defeat me, Doctor. Seriously, Carlifix? Seriously? You really did that right next to the box. Right. Wait, what? It's not even here in the circuits to defuse the missile. They aren't here. It was a trick. So, how do I stop this? I don't know if I can stop it. Ah, unless I use the TARDIS. I could use the TARDIS to re-engineer the missile. I could put a reverse engineered feedback pulse onto the missile and short circuit it before it even has a chance to disappear. So, the TARDIS, I believe. Right, TARDIS now. Right, here we go again. So, all I need to do is reverse engineer the feedback quadronic loop and then intersplice that with a little bit of the mainframe articulizers and an automatic quad reversal converging on one place in time and space, including the moon, and of course throwing a bit of Nitro 9. Love Nitro 9, nice bit of Aces style. Two more levers to go. Love it. Which ones? Ah, little wibbly levers. Wonder what they do. Little bit of Nitro 9 goes a long way. How far will I go for adventure? Well, blown up the moon. Well, part of the moon. Well, a missile on the moon. That's how far I'll go. Now, all I have to do is make sure it hasn't affected time and place a chronometric lock using the TARDIS to make sure it hasn't affected any known century. Oh. It does. It affects the moon landing. Oh no. That means I must have been in the past. But the Earth's past. Oh no. That means that now they know that there was something on the moon. They never went up there to explore. That is bad. So what do? I can't go back there and reassemble the missile, can I? Think. Library. Think library. Maybe there's something in the library. Right. There must be something in the 2000-year diary? Oh. That is so not good.